In casting up this great balance sheet and contemplating our dangers with a disillusioned eye, I see great reason for intense exertion and vigilance, but none whatever for panic or despair. The gratitude of every home in our island, in our empire, and indeed throughout the world, except in the abodes of the guilty, goes out to the British airmen who, undaunted by odds, unwearied in their constant challenge and mortal danger, are turning the tide of the world war by their prowess and by their devotion. Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few. All our hearts go out to the fighter pilots whose brilliant actions we see with our own eyes day after day. But we must never forget that all the time, night after night, month after month, our bomber squadrons travel far into Germany, find their targets in the darkness by the highest navigational skill, aim their attacks, often under the heaviest fire, often with serious loss, with deliberate careful discrimination, and inflict shattering blows upon the whole of the technical and war-making structure of the Nazi power. On no part of the Royal Air Force does the weight of the war fall more heavily than on the daylight bombers, who will play an invaluable part in the case of invasion, and whose unflinching zeal it has been necessary, in the meanwhile, on numerous occasions, to restrain. I hope, indeed I pray, that we shall not be found unworthy of our victory, if after toil and tribulation it is granted to us. For the rest, we have to gain the victory. That is our task.
Sirens blow.
Stop, look, and listen. 7, don't smoke. 8, help all the kiddies. Most of all, obey your air raid warden.
Lights. Wait for information. Most of all, obey your air raid warden.
Stop the panic, don't get in a huff. Our aim today is to call their bluff. Follow these rules and that is enough. Obey your